You may be seated. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, Administration, and Faculty of Hill Country Christian School of Austin, I extend a hearty welcome to the families and friends of the class of 2016. You are an important part of this morning's activities. For those who may be unfamiliar with the customs and traditions of our school, please note that this ceremony is both a baccalaureate service and a commencement exercise. It is a time for the school community to gather to worship and bless our Creator while we recognize and honor these graduates. In that spirit of reverence and celebration, let us remember our school motto, Soli Deo Gloria, as we dedicate these commencement exercises to the glory of God alone. This morning, we are privileged to have Mr. Steve Berry, Hill Country Bible Church Elder Board Liaison, to deliver our invocation.
I want to start by just reading a short passage from Proverbs chapter 2. My son, if you accept my words and store up my commands within you, turning your ear to wisdom and applying your heart to understanding, and if you call out for insight and cry aloud for understanding, and if you look for it as for silver and search for it as for hidden treasure, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. For the Lord gives wisdom, and from his mouth come knowledge and understanding. He holds victory in store for the upright. He is a shield to those who walk as blameless, for he guards the course of the just and protects the way of his faithful ones. Then you will understand what is right and just and fair, every good path, for wisdom will enter your heart, and knowledge will be pleasant to your soul. Discretion will protect you, and understanding will guard you. Let's pray. Father, we welcome your presence here today, and from the words we have read, I pray that the graduates will seek you earnestly, that they will store up your commands and will thus gain knowledge and understanding, for you have known them and had plans for their lives from before time began. So, Father, we pray that this day would be a day where not only will these students be blessed, but a day where you will be glorified and blessed above all else. And, Father, while we're here to celebrate all the hard work and efforts that these students have put forth, we're also here, Father, to celebrate you, for you're a good God, and it's because of you we're here. So, Father, we just want to pray your blessing upon this ceremony and pray your blessing upon these graduates. It's in the powerful name of Jesus we ask these things. Amen.
The 2002-2003 school year marked the institution of the Hill Country Christian School Court of Honor. The Court of Honor recognizes the member of each graduating class who best exemplifies the qualities of our godly acrostic over the course of his or her high school career. The letters of the godly acrostic represent the following: G, growing in relationship with God and man; O, obeying authorities; D, diligent in pursuit of knowledge, understanding, and wisdom; L, leading others in Christ-likeness; Y, yielding to God and his call. It is my pleasure to introduce Nathan Howard as the 14th member of the Hill Country Christian School Court of Honor. Nathan, please stand and be recognized. Nathan's name has been added to the Court of Honor plaque, which is displayed in the upper school office.
Each year, our seniors compose, present, and defend a senior thesis. In the classical tradition, we ask the students to exhibit logos, pathos, and ethos in their work. Nathan Howard was awarded this year's gold medal for his thesis on the topic, Relativism's Erosion of the Rule of Law Through Judicial Activism. I was blessed to be Nathan's faculty mentor for this project. Nathan certainly applied logos, or reason and judgment, to his carefully prepared arguments. Pathos was evident in Nathan's concern for his country and its citizens. But most of all, Nathan brought ethos, or his own character and credibility, to his work. This character has been evident to our school community in Nathan's servant leadership as president of the student council. He expressed sincerity and humility as he shared his Hill Country story at prospective parent meetings. Nathan's love for learning was obvious in his comments during senior philosophy class. And I witnessed Nathan's desire to know and to follow our Lord when we shared theological discussions before school. Nathan Howard, you are a gracious example of Romans 12:2. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. Nathan, would you join me on the stage? It is my distinct honor to recognize you as salutatorian of the class of 2016, and Nathan will now honor us with his salutatory address.
Good morning and welcome to all parents, staff, guests, and students of the 2016 graduating class. The Iron Lady, former Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, Margaret Thatcher, once said, "Look at a day in which you are supremely satisfied in the end. It's not a day when you lounge around doing nothing. It's a day when you've had everything to do and you've done it." Based on her criteria, I'd say that we can stand here satisfied. It's been a full 4 years of high school, 10 different sports, 22 graduating seniors, dozens of teachers, hundreds upon hundreds of hours of hard work, and a few thousand desperate Google searches. Well done, seniors. First and foremost, I'd like to thank the parents. Thank you for the sacrifices you've made. You've given us your time, your hearts, and your love. You've even given us a few spankings, but all because you love us and you want the best for us. I love you, Mom and Dad. Thank you, Hill Country faculty and staff. We may be leaving now, but we're not leaving the same. You've educated us, you've trained us, and you've shown us how to live and model our lives after Christ. And thank you, seniors. Words can't even begin to express the memories that we've had, the hard work that we've put in together, the laughs we've shared, the tears we've shed, and the time that we can never get back. From teddy bear parades to caps and gowns, each step along the way was filled with memories we won't forget. Leaving freshman dance for the luxurious Whataburger and watching as Noah fell asleep on his orange and white foam cup, face first. Driving to IHOP after Friday night football games where the cheerleaders lent their aromatic perfume to the football players so that we could sit together and still enjoy one another's company. Listening to Kate as he explained how you can win in the lottery and lose money at the same exact time. Spending our lunches together in the senior lounge, on park benches, or even in the bed of a pickup truck. And watching in awe as James played Star Wars, Titanic, and Amazing Grace on the recorder. Through his nose. Now, as we spring off into the world of college dorms and buying our own toilet paper, let's not forget the life lessons we've learned together. We've learned that forgiveness is hard, but it's worth it. We've learned that life is much more expensive than we once thought. And we've learned that how to live life with people who we might not have even talked to had we gone to a bigger school. The greatest lesson that I learned at Hill Country didn't exactly happen in a classroom. It wasn't reading a textbook, and it wasn't cramming for a last-minute quiz. I learned that I should never be ashamed of who I represent. And that lesson I learned from 21 of my best friends. From Holly's unceasing prayers to Seth's fearlessness on the baseball mound, from JD's presence on the theater stage, to Jordan's absolute honesty about anything and everything. Each of you have shown me at one point or another how to live life unashamed. And now I want to turn this challenge to you and encourage you to take your gifts unabashedly and run with them as fast and as far as you can. I've seen Cade's entrepreneurial genius, Colton's tender heart, Ryan's willingness to be a safe place, Avery's artistic savvy, John David's care for others, Adeline's mother-like heart, Cole's analytic mind, James's pure confidence, Seth's fearlessness, Maddie's cheerfulness, Ricky's Wikipedia-like brain, Ashley's grit, Jordan's open arms, Caroline's passion, Grace's servant heart, Sarah Jane's writing talent, Noah's video skills, Holly's thoughtfulness, Jonathan's diligence, Taryn's musical knack, and Blake's raw courage. Y'all, do not be ashamed of these gifts that God has given to you, please. Our world is already too filled with people who are too ashamed to stand up, too afraid to speak out, and too comfortable to get their hands dirty. Sometimes that's me, and that's us. That's a part of the human condition, but this is where we recognize that we cannot live unashamed and do it alone. Living unashamed, that we must first recognize that we are weak and He is strong. Strong enough to be our foundation as we leave a Christian school within a church for a college campus away from home. Strong enough to help us say no to some things so that we can say yes to the best things. And strong enough to allow us to live without our unnecessary fears, worries, and doubts. David wrote in Psalm 130, verse 6, "My soul waits for the Lord, more than watchmen for the morning." Had he lived a few thousand years later, I honestly think he might have written, "My soul waits for the Lord, more than seniors for their graduation." Let that be true of us. Let us understand who he is better than we comprehend economics. Let us live for Jesus in the next stage of our lives, no matter what the world around us thinks. And let us long for the Lord more than we've waited for this very, very exciting moment. I'd like to conclude with one more piece of wisdom from Margaret Thatcher. Reflecting on her young adulthood, she stated, "I think the toughest thing that my father taught me, it was very firmly indeed, you do not follow the crowd because you're afraid of being different. If necessary, you lead the crowd, but you never just follow. Oh, it was very hard, my goodness me. It stood me in good stead, though. Don't just follow the crowd. Let the crowd follow you." Thank you. Brown Foundation Scholar, Hunt Leadership Scholar, National Merit Scholar, Valedictorian. Over the last 4 years, Jonathan Innes has built an impressive resume. It's for this reason that he gets to speak to us today. But I would like to call your attention not to why he gets to speak, but to why you should listen. We challenge students to be servant leaders, to leave a legacy. Sadly, those terms have become cliche. Their meaning lost, reduced simply to leading by example. To be sure, Jonathan has led by example. He does hard things, asks hard questions, and challenges himself. Qualities that have made him an exceptional student. But exceptional students do these things for themselves, reaping the benefits for what they have sown. What sets Jonathan apart are the things that he does so that others can get the credit. Jesus taught us that those who want to be great should seek to serve, or as Bill Hybels put it, we must descend into greatness. Jonathan has done just that. A 4-year starting point guard with a pass-first mentality, he recognized that an assist is often better than a bucket. As yearbook editor, he handed out even more assists, understanding that his real value resided not in his ability to complete his own assignments, but in ensuring with his time and presence that his staff performed beyond their ability. He has built into the lives of others, made them better, multiplied himself. He's left a true legacy. And as such, it is my distinct pleasure not only to introduce, but to sit and listen to the valedictorian of the class of 2016, Jonathan Innes.
Honestly, this is the longest piece of clothing I've ever worn, so I'm thankful that I made it up the stairs without tripping, knowing the klutz I am. Students, faculty, parents who are sad to see their children leave the nest, and parents who started counting the days until their children would leave the nest 4 years ago, we've made it. Yeah. The day that we say goodbye to Hill Country and hello to college and the Marines, James Finley, is finally here. While some of us have been waiting for this day since the beginning of our ninth grade year, others of us have been dreading having to leave some of our friends that we've had since kindergarten. It is my hope that this speech will do justice to the last 4 years that all of us have spent together. We have learned to memorize an incredible amount of proofs in geometry, we have immersed ourselves in Sophie's world, and we have learned the safe way to waft dirt in earth science. The students of Hill Country Christian have proved that procrastination and apathy are not just big words, but can also be a way of life. Some of us knew exactly how much homework we didn't have to do to still pass a class. Ricky. While others of us thought that the off-campus senior eating privilege was the greatest part of the entire high school experience. And looking back, it seems like just yesterday, each of us was the newest fish in the Hill Country High School pond. The first class, the first test, the first MacBook, the second MacBook, the third MacBook, the realization that your class might have been the reason they stopped using MacBooks, the first Chromebook, the first time you felt that pen and paper might be a better alternative than a Chromebook, the first time you heard the term honors credit, and the last time you heard the term extra credit. The first time you understood that your lifelong dream of living off your parents' income wasn't exactly the best job path. The first time you understood that saying, I got it off of Wikipedia, it must be true, wasn't an acceptable MLA source. The first time and probably the last time you were involved in a Bigfoot club. The first time you learned that New Zealand wasn't in the middle of Europe. Noah Wallace, so boy. We need a geography class, I'm telling you. And the first time you learned that I cannot, under any circumstances, wakeboard. Looking at you, Avery Dooley. We've had so many firsts, and now it's time to experience some lasts. The last time walking into a high school classroom, the last high school exam, and the last time truly being together as a class. Throughout our time in high school, our teachers and faculty have sought to know us and to make us a group of extraordinary Christ-following graduates with incredible potential to change the world. Makes sense, I mean, we have people in this class who are athletically gifted, who are incredible speakers, and who are outstanding leaders. Still, some may think that we have built this school up, that we have left a legacy. And while this may be true, I see it the other way around. While it seems that we have left our mark on the school has left an even bigger mark on us. We have been surrounded by some of the best teachers that anyone could want. I mean, look at our English teachers, Mrs. Herring and Mrs. Heckel. They genuinely care about each of our lives. Mrs. Heckel has predicted what our lives will look like 10 to 20 years into the future. Mr. B has been an amazing chaplain, willing to open up about his personal testimony to make our Christian walk stronger. Mrs. Young has gotten to know each of us personally and accurately described every single one of us during senior chapel. Coach Horn, our dean of students and the person who hands out discipline, has become one of our best friends. Mrs. Wormell has opened up her home and let us be part of her daughter Story's life. And Mr. McGee, as our headmaster, has given up his personal time to get to know each and every one of us. And there's so many more. Thank you, faculty, for what you've done for us. So if there's one thing I've learned during my years at Hill Country, it's that the people around us have a bigger impact on our future than we realize. Don't take the people around you in college or in your career for granted. Your professors, friends, and coworkers will have a big impact on you. Surround yourself with friends who encourage you and build you up, and be willing to do the same for them. Let our light shine before men, as the Bible commands us to do. So as you take your last steps and prepare to experience a whole new set of firsts, keep in mind the wisdom of Dr. Seuss from his poem, Oh, the Places You'll Go. You'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know. You'll get mixed up with many strange birds as you go. So be sure where you step. Step with care and great tact. And remember that life's a great balancing act. Just never forget to be dexterous and deft, and never mix up your right foot with your left. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98.75% guaranteed. Kid, you'll move mountains. So be your name Buxbaum or Bixby or Bray or Mordecai, Alley, Von Allen, O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So get on your way. Thank you.
At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce you to our commencement speaker, Coach Gary Schofield. Coach Schofield is the head strength and conditioning coach at Greater Atlanta Christian School in Atlanta, Georgia. He also serves as the National Strength and Conditioning Association's Southeast Regional Coordinator. Coach Schofield is entering his 23rd year as a state-licensed certified athletic trainer, certified strength and conditioning specialist with distinction, as well as a registered strength and conditioning coach with distinction. His unique background of athletic training and strength and conditioning has allowed him to coach and assist in the development of athletes with teams and organizations in the National Basketball Association, Arena Football League, East Coast Hockey League, United States Basketball League, World Championship Wrestling, North American Soccer League, Georgia State Olympic Development Program, USA Track and Field Indoor Championships, and many other organizations. Coach Schofield received a Bachelor of Science degree in sports medicine with a special emphasis in athletic training from Marietta College in Ohio. He continued his education in athletic training at Georgia State University and earned a Master of Arts in teaching from the University of North Georgia. Coach Schofield was named the National High School Strength and Conditioning Coach of the Year in 2012. Because of his love for students and an even greater love for the Lord, for the past 6 years, under the leadership of Coach Schofield, Greater Atlanta Christian School has been awarded the Strength of America Award that recognizes schools exhibiting the highest standard in the success of young athletes. Coach Schofield is a sought-after speaker regionally, nationally, and internationally. On a personal note, Coach Schofield played a significant role in our daughter's spiritual and athletic development. In 2012, his influence in her life was clearly evident as she made valuable contributions to the University of Texas rowing team, resulting in a Big 12 championship. Please join me in giving a big Texas welcome to my colleague and dear friend, Coach Gary Schofield.
I know nothing says strength coach like a little guy in a boot. So please forgive me a little bit with that. I am absolutely humbled. First of all, I've noticed you've corralled me in with a little area. Normally I speak around and move around a little bit, so hopefully I'll be good today. But I am humbled to have been asked to share this special moment with you all. This past year I've been blessed to speak in over 15 states and 3 countries. I have won a few awards, and our program has been recognized over the years for developing what we like to refer to as monsters. A little Boston accent come out of me a little bit. A monster is simply an individual who inspires awe in others by doing what they thought to be impossible. And so we try to do that every day, and it's an absolute honor to get the opportunity to wake up every day for the students of Greater Atlanta Christian School. But with that being said, absolutely nothing would have stopped me from coming here, including this wonderful ruptured Achilles tendon. This is definitely, in a long career, the greatest professional honor I've ever received, to be able to speak here with you. Thank you so much for trusting for me to be part of this incredible family, which is what this is in front of me, for this special moment in your all's lives. For that, I am truly humbled. Today, before we get going, I want to make 3 promises to you, though. We'll give you 3 promises. The first promise is I promise to give you everything I got, as evidenced by this wonderful thing. Last Saturday at about this time, I was up speaking in front of about 270 coaches from across the country, and I demonstrated what I believe to be a simple exercise until I heard what I thought was a gunshot, and it was my calf rolling up the back of my leg. And so I did hop up, I did finish, I did wrap it up, and I did a demo session in the afternoon. How? I have no idea. But I did that, so today I promise not to do that. So we won't do that. I also promise to do everything I can to make this entertaining. Make it engaging. You heard one of the wonderful experiences I've had of WCW wrestling, and there was a time where I was absolutely power-bombed in the middle of a ring on a Monday night show by Kevin Nash and Hulk Hogan, so I carefully looked behind that screen to make sure there was no one waiting on me, so that should not happen again. And then the third promise is probably the most important promise. I promise to make this short, because if I fail to deliver on the first two, at least you have the third one to hang on to. So, boy, I remember sitting there, Hull High School, Hull, Massachusetts, in my gown, that nervous excitement about what was coming. Boy, I remember. I want to tell you that it wasn't that long ago, but the gray poking out of my beard and the lack of hair on my head would tell you otherwise, so I'm not going to lie to you. But it feels just like yesterday. I would also like to tell you how riveted I was to the commencement speaker, but I have no idea who that was or what he said. So I understand what my role is up here today. but that nervous excitement, that, boy, what's in store for me? What will I do? What kind of life am I going to have? What role am I going to have? What profession am I going into? Heck, what major am I going to have? That undecided major probably doesn't lead to a great profession, so we need to find something down the line. What is it going to be? Man, in many ways, I envy you. I envy that start. But the old man in me tells you that I know what kind of world you're unfortunately going into a bit. And so I think I need to share a little bit about what you're headed into. And as any good strength coach, I'm going to refer to the movie Rocky. And hopefully the new movie Creed has made it relevant. You do know who Rocky is, right? Okay. All right, so thankfully for that movie. But there is a quote. I think it's the greatest movie quote of all time. Yes, coming from Rocky. And it's from, there were a series, 1 and 2 were pretty good. There was a series of ugh. And then there was a Rocky Balboa that came out. And then he was talking to his son who was trying to make his way in life. And his son was bothered by this shadow of his dad, Rocky. And he was outside talking to him. And he said, listen, I'm going to tell you something you already know. Life ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and it will beat you to your knees permanently if you let it. Not me, you, or anybody going to hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you can hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, don't go around pointing your fingers, blaming him or her or anybody for not being where you want to be. If you know what you're worth, go out and get what you're worth. but you got to be willing to take the hits. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that. Man, I remember hearing that, and I had to see the movie 8 times as if I wouldn't have already. But I had to see the movie again because I forgot what came next because that was so powerful. This idea of keeping moving forward. This idea that it wasn't about how hard I could hit, but how much I could take and keep moving forward. You're about to leave your home. You're about to leave teachers that love you. You're about to leave parents that love you and friends that love you. You're about to leave coaches that love you. You're about to leave a place that gave you everything you can to, for you to be as great as you can. Parents that gave everything you can for you to be as great as you can. And you're about ready to enter a world that wants to know what it can get from you, not what it can give to you. You're going to get an employer that wants to get something from you and a college that needs you to get a grade or get a degree. And that small change is not so small. That may be the biggest change. I don't minimize that shift. That shift is huge. This world will challenge everything that you believe. It will challenge everything. Physically, you're going to be told that you're too short to be a strength coach, that you have the wrong accent, you have the wrong skin color, you're just not good enough, you're just not pretty enough. We live in a culture, in a world that is outside specific. It's what it sees on the outside, not what's truly on the inside. You all know that because of the family that you have, but the world is so outside driven. Don't believe me? Turn the TV on. Just look at the visions that you have. Look what marketing does, because it sells. It's outside driven. You have that culture waiting you on physical. Mentally, you're going to be told that you're not smart enough. You didn't go to a big enough high school. You didn't go to the right school. You didn't get the right degree. You don't have a certification. You didn't pass the test. You didn't get a good enough grade. Oh, you got a 90, but that person got a 96. And you're going to find this strange world that lives in this fixed mindset, and I know you've heard these things before, as opposed to a growth mindset that tells me, let's find out how smart you can be. Let's find out how tough you can be. I have kids come to me every day and say, Coach, I'm just not fast enough. And my answer is immediate and quick and say, let's find out how fast you can be. Let's find out. Why don't we explore that? Let's find out. Well, what if I fail? So what if you do? Who cares? Let's find out. And spiritually, that might be the biggest shock of them all. It's something that I didn't have to experience, but you will. There's a good book out there now called Good Faith. And it talks about the change in the Christian culture in our country that it's going through right now. And Christianity is challenged. It's looked at by many to be extreme or, at best case, irrelevant. Don't believe me? I never thought in my lifetime the choice of a bathroom would be optional. And now it is. You are going to be challenged in every belief structure that you now hold and future will hold. So why am I telling you this? Well, man, this world I'm talking about is awful dang scary. And it is. But maybe. Maybe it is. Cowards get scared. And that ain't you. You're better than that. You were raised better than that. So what do you do? What answer can I give you? What defense can I give you for this world that you're going into so that you can hold strong and that you can keep moving forward? I can give you 4 letters. G-R-I-T, grit, and I know you've heard of that before. Grit, passion, and perseverance. Angela Duckworth has written a fantastic book called Grit. If you haven't read that book, I would highly advise it. It will prepare you well. Grit, find something you're passionate about, and I don't care what they say, keep going. I'm a little guy. I'm a strength coach. I can't tell you how many times and how many doors were shut in my face because I'm a little guy. And now they sit in the audience and watch me blow my tendon as I'm teaching them. Keep going. Keep going. Keep holding true. You don't have to give them an answer because no answer will suffice. It won't. You can't tell them because they won't listen. That's okay. You keep going. You persevere with passion. You don't let anyone drown that out of you. Find what you want and continue on. I can't give you that best answer, but I can give you the best example. The best example from the best person, the best example we've ever had in Christ. Christ came to this earth And he experienced hatred and greed and jealousy, injustice, discrimination, lies. And you know what he did? He kept moving forward. He carried the cross for our sins, not his. And he stumbled and he fell. You know what he did? Get up and he kept moving forward. He kept moving forward so much that he rolled that stone away. And he cheated death its victory. And he kept moving forward. And it doesn't make sense to the world. They don't get it. Say, that's impossible. I don't understand that. And it leaves them grasping at why the tomb is empty and there's no grave to go see. And he uses that because he kept moving forward. He had passion for us and a perseverance that would not let anything get in the way of you. Nothing would stop him. Could have. He could have in an instant called down angels with a whisper. He kept moving forward. That's grit. His love for us left no limits to what he would do. So here's what I will leave with you. No matter what comes your way, and there will be a lot coming your way, good and bad, embrace the good, persevere the bad. Remember three simple words. When it seems you're alone, and there will be times in college you will, I remember as a freshman being crushed for the first time being alone. And I thought, oh, I'm going to be a big, tough guy. And I remember getting down in my tiny little closet, because everything is tiny in college, tiny little closet, and crying, really, for the first time. I am not an overly emotional guy, which is probably good for a strength coach. Passionate, not overly emotional, but crying and not knowing what was going on. And I looked up underneath the rail of the closet, and it said, don't worry, it gets better. I had a laugh. I know that was left by a person, but I looked up to the sky and said, okay, God, all right. Just remember those three words. When you're struggling, keep moving forward. I congratulate you. I congratulate this place. I congratulate you, teachers. I know how much you give. Now it's on your shoulders to go change this wonderful world we live in. Congratulations and good luck. Thank you.
Think of you as I go, so when I leave, you're not alone. And no matter where you are, we will never be that far. I'll think of you as I go. I'll think of you as I dream. So when it's dark, you'll be with me. And no matter where you are, we can look up to the stars. And I will think of you as I dream.
Oh, it's a long and winding road.
Long and winding road. Have to walk alone.
I'll think of you
when I'm down
when my heart
is on the ground
I'll never lose my way
I will think of you when I'm down
with the long and winding road
It's a long and winding road, but you don't have to walk alone. 'Cause no matter where you are, I will keep you in my heart.
And I will
think of you, think of you, think of you as I go.
Thank you, High School Ensemble. Thank you, Ms. Brewer, for your leadership in putting that together, and Mrs. Stewart for your leadership of our lower school choirs, our music program. Absolutely. And thank you, Gary, for your inspirational words and also for modeling grit for us. Ladies and gentlemen of the class of 2016, you were not the only ones consumed with finals in the closing weeks of the school year. I had my own finals over the past few weeks, but my finals have not consisted of studying for a semester's worth of notes or preparing for my senior thesis. My finals have been events-oriented. My final chapel, my final awards ceremony, my final theater arts performance, my final board meeting, yay, and so on and so on. But undoubtedly, this final commencement ceremony is the one event that I will miss most. I'm guessing that I have attended more high school graduations than anyone in this auditorium. For 35 years, well, 34 if you don't count the videotape presence 5 years ago when I could not be present because of surgery, I have witnessed countless students cross the stage to receive their diploma. In all those years, nobody does it better than Hill Country. I can't tell you how many guests that have attended a Hill Country graduation have come up to me following the service to tell me that this was the most impressive ceremony they've ever witnessed. This is truly a cherished tradition that Jana and I are going to greatly miss. In my final charge to you graduates, I draw on the words of Christian scholar, apologist, and author C.S. Lewis. You know him. You've read several books written by him. Who once said, "Good philosophy must exist, if for no other reason, because bad philosophy must be answered." Look around. It's not hard to see that bad philosophy permeates our society, our culture, and our institutions. Bad philosophy spews from the mouths of the presumptive nominees for president of both parties. Bad philosophy is prompting our current president to issue executive orders that would have been unfathomable in previous administrations. Social media is saturated with bad philosophy. The entertainment industry produces movies and plays, concerts and TV shows based on bad philosophy. And mark my word, graduates, you will encounter plenty of bad philosophy on your college campus next fall. In fact, the college campus is a bastion for bad philosophy. So forewarned is forearmed. But ladies and gentlemen, this is not a new issue. 2,000 years ago, in his letter to the Colossian church, the Apostle Paul warned, "See to it that no one takes you captive through hollow and deceptive philosophy, which depends on human tradition and the basic principles of this world, rather than on Christ." And again in his letter to the Corinthian church, Paul writes, "Where is the wise man? Where's the scholar? Where's the philosopher of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world?" You see, bad philosophy has been around for thousands of years. So what's a believer to do when inundated and challenged with bad philosophy? Well, the antidote to anything is its opposite. You overcome bad, not with more bad, but with doing good. The Word of God makes that point over and over. Jesus instructs us not to return evil for evil, but to defeat evil with good. To love our enemies, not hate them. To turn the other cheek, not strike back. to a lost and broken world, that kind of philosophy is foolish. Yet it was this kind of foolishness that turned the world upside down. And it will be this kind of foolishness that will defeat the world's wisdom. Ladies and gentlemen of the class of 2016, Hill Country Christian School has provided you an education baptized by the truth of God's Word. We have encouraged you to seek the truth of the gospel and apply that truth to all areas of life. We have provided you with opportunities to develop a better understanding of the world, relationships, and issues through the lens of God's Word. And I am confident that you are well prepared to take on the bad philosophy that is about to confront you. Therefore, my final charge to you is the same charge Paul gave to the church of Corinth. Be on your guard. Stand firm in the faith. Be men and women of courage. Be strong. Do everything in love. Godspeed, class of 2016. Mr. Dietz, would you join me at the podium? Mr. Dietz and distinguished members of the Board of Trustees, I hereby certify that the students here assembled have successfully completed the prescribed curriculum and all requirements for graduation from Hill Country Christian School of Austin. On behalf of the faculty, I therefore recommend that they be awarded a diploma with all the honor, rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Mr. McGee, upon the recommendation of the faculty and by the authority vested in me in the Board of Trustees of Hill Country Christian School of Austin, I hereby authorize you to commence with the presentation of the class of 2016 for the conferring of diplomas.
Mr. Dietz, whereas the parents of Hill Country Christian School of Austin's class of 2016 have partnered with the school in their joint commitment to produce godly students to the glory of God alone. And whereas the class of 2016 will be representatives to the world of their families and the Lord Jesus Christ, I request that each family be granted the opportunity to join their graduate on the platform as we send them into the world.
Mr. McGee, I joyfully concur with your request.
One of the benefits of having a graduating class of 22 students is that it affords us the opportunity for the graduates and their parents to have a more intimate graduation exercise. As each graduate and their parents come to the platform, we will share an abbreviated version of the parent's charge to their graduate that appears in your program. At the conclusion of each portrait, the family will send their son or daughter to receive his or her diploma, symbolizing the fact that they are sending their child into the world as a representative of Jesus Christ, their family, and this school.
I am pleased to welcome Mr. Dave Fionda, our Department Chair for Math and Science, to join me as we award the diplomas. Jordan Andrews. It's hard to believe that our baby girl is now graduating from high school. We are so proud of you and the fine young woman you have become. Jeremiah 29:11 promises that the Lord knows the plans he has for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future. As you venture off to college and face the unknown, trust in God to guide your steps and deliver you through life's journeys. As Philippians 1:6 tells us, he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Jordan Ashley Andrews.
Madison Brewer. Today marks one of your many accomplishments you will have in your life. I am so proud of the woman you've become, and I look forward with great anticipation to all that you will accomplish in the future. My charge to you comes from Romans 12:2. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. Madison Valerie Brewer.
Caroline Carver. You are a beautiful and intelligent young woman. Our hope is that you pursue your dreams, listen to your heart, and always believe in yourself. What you will accomplish and what you will become are stories yet to unfold. Your dad and I, along with every person in your life, love you. We are so proud and we can't wait to see what you do next. Psalms 20 4 tells us, may he give you the desires of your heart and make all your plans succeed. Caroline McCain Carver.
Cade Cottrell. As you embark on adulthood, we are excited to see you spread your wings. Our charge to you is stated in Isaiah 4, 29 through 31. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Son, remember who lives in you and through you, for he will see you through everything. Cade Allen Cottrell.
Avery Dooley. Your birth announcement had James 1:17 on it. Every good and perfect gift is from above, and what a beautiful gift you've been in our lives. Quickly, the time has flown since we walked you into Hill Country that first day of first grade. Now stands before us this witty, independent, artistic, level-headed, and loving young woman. As you head to the Pacific Northwest, our charge to you is to be the light that God created you to be. Remember, you have the light of the world in you, so let that light so shine before men. Find joy in honoring him in all that you do. Avery Elise Dooley.
Cole Duncan. You have grown into the amazing person you are as a result of the path you have chosen to follow and the choices you have made. You are intelligent, tender-hearted, and brave, and you bring joy and light to the people in your life. We are in awe of the man you have become and blessed to call you son. We look forward to the amazing life you have yet to live and pray you will always put Christ first in your life. Cole Randall Duncan.
Sarah Jane Farrell. You have been a joy and delight to us from the day you were born. We have been greatly blessed to watch you grow, not only in years, but in wisdom and godliness. As you finish this chapter of your life at Hill Country, and begin a new one at the University of Texas, we pray that you will continue to trust the Lord, walk in His truth, and pursue Him with your whole heart. 1 Thessalonians 5 teaches us to be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Sarah Jane Farrell.
James Finley, you have made us so proud in everything that you have accomplished. You have proven yourself to persevere with the challenges of life. You know freedom isn't free and have enlisted in the United States Marine Corps. John 15:13 states, greater love has no man than this, than he lay down his life for his friends. We pray that God will strengthen you through his Holy Spirit always, and remember that you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. James Sheridan Finley.
John David Horton, you have given our family much laughter and joy over the past 18 years. We are very proud of you and are excited for you as you begin this new chapter in your life. We are confident that the talents God has given you will take you far, and we pray you will learn to deal with life's ups and downs with humility and laughter. We will be watching from afar as you accomplish your goals. Always seek God's will in all that you do and the choices you make. John David Horton.
Nathan Howard, you have grown from a principled boy into a young man of integrity, full of conviction and purpose. We are exceedingly proud of you. God has rewarded your diligent efforts with a great launching point for life's next phase. We will dearly miss you at home, but it is time you engage the world and battle for the kingdom in college and beyond. As Psalm 37 tells us, trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and befriend faithfulness. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Nathan Eugene Howard.
Jonathan Ennis, we are so proud of you and your accomplishments, and we know that God has great things in store for you. Going forward, never forget whose you are and who you are. You belong to Christ. Stay grounded in Him and continue to let Him lead and transform you. You are also a representative not only of Christ, but also your family, this school, and the church. Be different. Be a light in a world of darkness. As Jesus stated in Matthew 5, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Jonathan Edward Ennis.
Seth Jackson, it is a blessing to call you our son and to have watched you grow in wisdom and stature as you have journeyed into manhood. God has blessed you immensely, and we are proud of the many accomplishments you have made throughout your high school years. Today is a day to celebrate the end of your Hill Country era and mark the beginning of the new adventure God has planned for you. We pray God will use you mightily for his purpose at Texas A&M and beyond. We look forward to witnessing all that he has planned for you. Seth Brennan Jackson.
Ryan Long. God blessed us with a wonderful son we are thankful for every day. We are so proud of all of your achievements, and we look forward to what your future holds. Be courageous, maintain your love of life, and pursue your dreams. Henry Ford said, "When everything seems to be going against you, remember that the airplane takes off against the wind, not with it." Our charge to you is to face challenges with confidence, seek adventure, listen to your heart, and keep Christ as your guide. Ryan Christopher Long.
Blake Lundstrom. We are proud of you. Standing before us, we see a bold and courageous man of God. You have tackled incredible obstacles in life with the full force of who God made you to be. Our charge to you is to follow Jesus with all you are. Seek your Father God daily. Stay in his word constantly. Pray continually for discernment. And surround yourself with men and women of God to hold you accountable in living out your calling and purpose. Blake Aaron Lundstrom.
Adeline Pierman. Here at this very moment in time exists both a beginning and an end, bridged by a bond of love. Though this beginning inevitably distances you from us as parents, as it must, our love, pride, and hope at both this beginning and end remain forever and always. Your own beginnings and ends are in your hands and will be guided by your faith. Remember Psalms 119, "Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path," and Isaiah 41:10, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God." Adeline Elaine Pierman.
Colton Radney. Your mother and I feared this day would not be possible, but son, you've made it. With God's help, you have persevered through challenges most do not understand. You are a special young man for whom God has a special plan. As you embark on your next phase of challenges, we ask that you continue to be guided by Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do, and he will show you which path to take. Colton James Radney.
Ashley Reed. We know the path to today has been long and winding, full of challenges, setbacks, successes, hard decisions, and fun. You have made us proud in everything you have accomplished. When you were confirmed, you chose to live by the scripture verse, Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Remember this verse, and remember that God has a plan for you. We know you will succeed if you let him lead the way. Ashley Nicole Reed.
Taryn Surratt. We've watched you as you've grown from our spirited little boy to a handsome man of integrity, ready to face the world. We pray that you will go from here with your dreams and always trust in Christ. Colossians 1, 9 through 10. And so, from the day we heard, we have not ceased to pray for you, asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of his will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding, so as to walk in a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to him, bearing fruit in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God. Taryn Ray Surratt.
Grace Tinsley. You are inquisitive, compassionate, adventurous, sensitive, thoughtful, determined, and loyal. We have seen you dream big, work hard, accomplish much, and persevere through some tough challenges. We admire your commitment to seeking God and his will, knowing that he loves you. We encourage you to love him, abide in him, rely upon him, and serve others empowered by him. We are excited to see you continue to grow as the godly woman you are uniquely designed to be. Grace Elizabeth Tinsley.
Ricky Trent. We have loved and nurtured you since you were born, from starting at 1 foot and 8.5 inches to today at 6 feet and 5 inches. It has been an exciting journey. We have prepared you to the best of our ability. Once in a while, you may feel a little alone. We say to you on this day, keep the Lord close to your heart and you will never be alone. Remember Proverbs 4:7. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and in all you're getting, get understanding. Richard Beckett Trent.
Noah Wallace. Given your love for wakeboarding, we can't help but think about Jesus telling his friends to step out of the boat, not settling for a common experience, but embracing the life-changing adventure he had for them. So, step out confidently, knowing Jesus will never fail you, that he is the only one that will quench your thirst, and that he really is a good, good daddy. You truly are brilliantly talented and persevered through a challenging senior year, proudly displaying your love for people more than things. We can't wait to see what God holds for your future at Clemson this fall. Noah Andrew Wallace.
Holly Wedgeworth. You have always been a girl who does things her own way, on her own time. It's not that you're stubborn, it's your tenacious spirit. We thank God for gifting you this way. It will serve you well. You are ready to move on, you are confident and secure, and you are so blessed. Never forget that the things God intends for you go far beyond anything you can imagine. Philippians 4:19 says, and my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus. Holly Elaine Wedgeworth.
Will the seniors please stand and move to the front of the platform? In recognition of your graduation, please move your tassel from the right to the left. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure to present the Hill Country Christian School of Austin, graduated class of 2016. Ladies and gentlemen, following the benediction, please remain in your seats until the graduates, administration, and faculty have completed the recessional. We invite you to join us in the first floor cafe for a reception honoring the class of 2016. At this time, I would like to invite one of our senior parents and executive director of Christian Life, Mr. Richard Tinsley, who will close our time of celebration in prayer.
Please bow with me in prayer. Father God, today is a great day to rejoice and to give thanks. And we are grateful to you, God. We thank you, Lord, for bringing us to this place at this time and in your name. We thank you, God, for your covenant, steadfast love for each one of us, God. I thank you for each student, God, that you have given the grace to persevere, the grace to do well, the grace to have grit when needed, and the grace, God, to love you and to love others well. I thank you, Lord, for each family that's represented here today. Thank you for the parents, all of the time and love and effort and investment that they've put into each one of these students. And God, we pray your blessing and peace upon them, upon extended family members, brothers and sisters, grandparents, aunts and uncles, and those close friends, God, who are here today to celebrate this wonderful occasion to rejoice. I thank you, God, for each teacher and coach and mentor that has poured and invested into the lives of each student. We thank you, God, for your grace, your favor you've given us through the gospel of Christ, and your empowerment through your Holy Spirit. I thank you, God, for each accomplishment, each victory, and we also thank you, God, for the hard times, struggles, and challenges that have been unique to each student. We remember, God, that these help to nurture a humility and a dependence upon you. Thank you, Father, for preparing them for the path. We are grateful, God, for the plans that you have for each one of them, with the gifts, the talents, and knowledge that you have blessed them with. And as you guide them, we ask that they will continue to seek you in your word and prayer, and in a community with others who know and love you, and ultimately to fulfill the vocation that you have for each one of them by using their gifts, talents, and knowledge to serve others. We thank you for the assurance that you give to each one of them that they are never alone. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.
Living for tomorrow, lost within a dream, trying to find the answer to the question, and it seems love makes the world feel good. Singing in the moonlight, dancing in the rain, Let the sun shine through to lift your spirit once again. Cause love makes the world feel good. Chasing after rainbows, somewhere in the